Hello people and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Deep Roy Choudhury and I'm just a normal guy who talks about stuff that seems interesting and important to me. Today I'm going to talk about the importance of going for therapy. I might have talked about this in some shape or form in my before also, but still I think it is very necessary for people to listen or at least to talk about it, because mental health is still a very, very taboo topic to discuss. I mean, I myself don't like talking about my own, my own problems. I'm not talking about mental health, but I'm talking about, if I am the kind of person who is a very private kind of person, who doesn't like to share his emotions or his emotional baggage with other people. I generally try to stay private as a very private person. But again, it has its own drawbacks. I mean, after a point, you just sometimes you might need someone to talk to. You might need someone to share your problems with. I mean, if you just keep it bottled up within yourself, after a point, it really gets very, very stressful and very, very harmful for you, both mentally and physically, because you are not only always depressed or always anxious because of something that is going on in your mind, but you're also not able to focus on your work. You're also not able to focus on spending some time with your family. You know, these things are also affected because of your continued emotional baggage, I guess. So I have heard of an instance. I was watching a podcast, and one of the people said that one of his friends, the people who was there on that video, the person who was there on that video, one of his friends, he said that he goes for therapy from time to time, not because he has a specific kind of mental health problem, not because he's ill or anything, but everything might be going on pretty normal in his life, but still he just wants to talk to someone. He wants to talk to someone, wants to just unwind, I guess. And if someone is going through a problem, if a person is going through a problem, then that person might get some kind of help from the therapist, not just therapy. It can be a counselor, it can be a psychiatrist. I don't know the difference between these professions. Psychiatrist, therapist, and mental health professional or counselor. I don't necessarily know the difference between these three professions, but again, I'm not an expert on this topic. I'm just giving you my own layman's perspective on this issue. All I'm just trying to encourage you to do is basically take some time for yourself. All that I'm encouraging you to. If you cannot go to a therapist and talk to someone face to face, that's also fine. I mean, you don't have to do that. There can be other ways that you can get therapy. I mean, a lot of people say that sports is pretty therapeutic. A lot of people say that playing a musical instrument can be very therapeutic. For me, stand-up comedy is very therapeutic. Whenever I'm a little bit I feel a little bit let down, I just start watching stand-up comedy, and it really, really helps me unwind and helps me relax. It really helps me relax, and that is one thing that I like. I mean, in the same way, I'm pretty sure that it is not always possible for people to go and avail the services of a therapist, of a trained mental health professional. Sometimes people have the money, but sometimes people just don't want to share their problems with someone. In that case, you can go to a religious leader. As I want, religious leader, it can be a priest, rabbi, imam, a temple priest, priest in a Hindu temple, or a monk in a Buddhist monastery, whatever it is, you can go there for some spiritual guidance, for some guidance in your own life. And you can find, you might be able to find something something useful that you are looking for in your life, some kind of direction in your life. I mean, it's not necessarily that you always have a problem and that's why you're seeking guidance from someone. Although it's a bit different from therapy, but I guess therapy is also a kind of guidance in your life. You are being guided to a better mental state, I guess. I guess therapy is kind of like that. Again, I'm not an expert. I'm giving you a very layman's perspective. Don't take my word for as some expert opinion. I'm not an expert. I'm just giving you my perspective that, you know, all mental, I think the basic objective of a mental health professional is to make you better, make you feel better, make you help, you know, get out from a bad state mentally. If you are depressed or if you are anxious or if you have any kind of issue in your mind, you know, if you are depressed, if you are anxious, if you are just exhausted mentally, you know, just one visit to a therapist can invigorate you, sorry for that, or energize you, that's an easier word, energize you in many ways. And or you can go out for a movie. Watching a movie can also be very therapeutic. Go for go watch a stand-up comedy show, a live show, that would be amazing. Go out for dinner with a loved one, that would also be very therapeutic, I would say. So there are many ways of getting therapy, quote unquote therapy. More on this in the next video. Until then, please consider liking this video if you liked it. Please consider sharing this video with your friends and acquaintances, and please consider subscribing to my channel. That would help me a lot. Until the next video, stay safe, goodbye, and God bless you.